My name is Rohan Kadekodi, and I will present our work on WineFS, a huge page aware file system for persistent memory that ages gracefully. Optane DC persistent memory is a new memory technology by Intel. It is a non-volatile and fast medium, meaning that it can retain data across power cycles, and it has access latencies similar to that of DRAM. There are two ways in which applications primarily access data on persistent memory. The first way is through POSIX system calls. Legacy applications access data by issuing read and write system calls to the underlying persistent memory aware file systems. The second way of accessing data on persistent memory is by memory mapping files. Due to its unique characteristics, newer applications that are developed on persistent memory try to access data directly from user space without entering the kernel. These applications are called memory mapped applications. The applications first allocate space on persistent memory using fallocate or ftruncate calls to a persistent memory aware file system. The applications then memory map the files into user space. After this, the applications perform direct loads and stores to the allocated space on persistent memory from user space without going into the kernel. Page table mappings are used to convert virtual addresses to physical addresses on persistent memory. The first access of a page leads to a page fault that sets up page table entries. Frequently accessed pages are cached in the TLB for reducing address translation overhead. The performance of memory mapped applications depends on the number of page faults and TLB misses incurred by applications while performing loads and stores in the runtime. In order to alleviate the overhead of page faults, modern hardware and kernels support huge pages, which are basically larger pages, 2 megabytes or 1 gigabyte in size. Huge pages reduce the number of page faults and TLB misses by up to 500x. A file needs to be allocated using 2 megabyte contiguous and aligned extents in order to be mapped using huge pages. As shown below, the file on the right is contiguous and aligned to 2 megabyte boundaries and can be mapped using huge pages. The other two files are either fragmented or unaligned to 2 megabyte extent boundaries and cannot be mapped using huge pages. Hence, file systems play an important role in the performance of memory mapped applications. Another important point is that file systems must preserve huge pages or the aligned extents with age. This brings me to the next topic. What is aging and why should we care about it? Aging is the state of file systems as a result of constant allocations and deallocations over a long period of time, typically years. Google, in their talk about cluster storage systems, mentioned that they want to keep disks full and busy to avoid excess inventory costs. The figure on the left shows their disk utilization, where every box is a disk and the colors show disk spindle utilization. Majority of the disks are almost completely utilized and the free space is extremely fragmented. Thus, aging leads to fragmentation of free space, increasing the number of page faults in memory mapped applications. For measuring the impact of aging on different file systems, we perform a simple experiment where we memory map a 1 gigabyte file and perform sequential writes using memcopies of 4 KB each to the file. Y-axis shows the bandwidth of the memcopy commands where higher is better, and X-axis shows the utilization of the partition on which we perform the experiment. When freshly created, ext4 is able to achieve a bandwidth of greater than 4 gigabytes per second. However, when aged, the bandwidth of memcopies on ext4 DAX drops as the utilization increases. At 90% utilization, the bandwidth of aged ext4 DAX drops by more than half compared to freshly formatted ext4 DAX. Similarly, the bandwidth of Nova drops when aged, especially at higher levels of utilization. Hence, aging significantly degrades the performance of ext4 DAX and Nova. In order to solve this problem, we propose WineFS, which is a huge page aware file system for persistent memory that ages gracefully. WinFS uses a novel alignment aware allocation policy to preserve huge pages. WinFS achieves high performance for a wide range of applications that access files using memory mappings as well as POSIX system calls. WinFS is designed to achieve high scalability and works well with multiple NUMA nodes. The performance of WinFS stays the same when aged. In some memory mapped applications, aged WinFS actually performs better than freshly formatted Nova. WinFS is open sourced on GitHub. In the rest of the talk, we discuss about the insight behind WinFS and the techniques used by WinFS for achieving high performance. The first insight, as mentioned before, is that file systems need to allocate files on aligned and contiguous extents in order to be mapped using huge pages. Existing file systems such as ext4 DAX and XFS DAX strive to preserve the contiguity of free space with age, but fail to preserve alignment of free space. We now discuss the alignment aware policy of WinFS. Let us consider that the free space contains fragments that are as follows. The fragments on the left are smaller fragments that are unaligned, while the fragments on the right are all 2 megabytes in size and aligned to huge page boundaries on persistent memory. WinFS maintains 2 data structures in DRAM for managing free space. The holes or unaligned extents are managed by a red-black tree, while the huge page aligned extents are managed by a linked list. Small allocation requests of smaller than 2 MB is forwarded to the red-black tree and satisfied by a hole. 2 megabyte allocation requests are forwarded to the huge page list and use up aligned 2 megabyte extents. Allocations that are larger than 2 megabytes are broken down into multiple allocations of 2 megabytes and are satisfied using the huge page list, while the remainder is satisfied by the red-black tree. A small deallocation request is forwarded to the red-black tree. If there is a contiguous free extent to the deallocated extent, it is merged. If the merging results in a 2 megabyte aligned extent, it is moved to the huge page list and huge pages are reclaimed. To summarize, WinFS places large files of memory mapped applications in aligned huge page extents and small files of POSIX system call applications in unaligned holes. WinFS aggressively reclaims huge pages on file deallocations and deletions. Second insight of WinFS is that file systems should achieve high scalability for POSIX system call applications without causing fragmentation of free space for the memory mapped applications. The per inode log of Nova fragments free space, and the per process log of Strata wastes huge pages by using them up for POSIX system call applications that do not need huge pages. WinFS uses per CPU journals and allocation groups for achieving high scalability. WinFS further uses a hybrid data consistency mechanism of data journaling and copy on write for providing strong consistency guarantees while avoiding free space fragmentation. WinFS contains metadata structures to specific regions on persistent memory that avoids fragmentation of free space. Please refer to our paper for the details of the above techniques. We now discuss the evaluation of WinFS on Intel Optane DC persistent memory. We compare WinFS with other state-of-the-art file systems on a wide variety of memory mapped and POSIX system call applications in the paper. We answer 3 main questions in our evaluation. What is the memory map performance of WinFS when aged? What is the POSIX system call performance of WinFS when freshly formatted and aged? And is WinFS scalable? In this talk, we will answer the first question. We first check the performance of WinFS on an aged setup in the same experiment as before. The performance of WinFS consistently stays at greater than 4 gigabytes per second with increasing utilization. We now measure the performance of WinFS on YCSP benchmark run on top of RocksDB with memory mapped reads and writes. The y-axis shows throughput with respect to EXT4 DAX, and the x-axis, we have the YCSB standard workloads. WinFS outperforms other file systems on all YCSB workloads. In the load A workload, WinFS outperforms other file systems by approximately 50% while suffering from 30x fewer page faults in this workload compared to Nova. To conclude, WinFS demonstrates that it is possible to design a file system that achieves high performance for memory mapped applications and high performance for legacy POSIX applications while maintaining this high performance in the presence of aging and under high utilization. We have open sourced WinFS on GitHub, and we encourage you to try it out. Thank you.